In this meeting, I address the problem of renewal of guidelines for the treatment of hypertension, and specifically what we should do with blood pressure lowering effects. Now, there is a trend in current research to suggest that we should be a bit more aggressive in lowering blood pressure with antihypertensive drugs. That is to reduce blood pressure not just to less than 140 millimeter mercury systolic in the general hypertensive population, or less than 150 millimeter mercury in the elderly population, but try to go as close as possible to 130 millimeter mercury systolic, or even less if treatment is well tolerated. And there is a lot of evidence that in most conditions in which blood pressure is elevated, this indeed leads to an incremental reduction of cardiovascular events. And so recent American guidelines, for example, have adopted a lower blood pressure target in order to maximize cardiovascular protection of hypertensive patients. But there is one other element of novelty in future guidelines, probably, and this is to try to address even more effectively what is a devastating problem in the hypertension area. That is that although treatment allows, in principle, to control blood pressure in the majority of the hypertensive population, this is hardly achieved in clinical practice. Only one out of five out of six patients has blood pressure control. And this problem will be even worse now that there is a tendency for target blood pressure to be lower than in the past. How can we cope with this? Well, many hypertensiologists, clinicians and researchers recommend to use combination treatment, not just one drug, in order to more effectively control blood pressure. And there is now recent evidence that if we start the treatment with a combination of two drugs rather than one drug, long-term blood pressure control can be much better. Now, we hope that this will be implemented in the future, because hypertension is the number one cause of death worldwide. And only if we increase substantially the number of patients with blood pressure control throughout the world can hypertension step down from this undesired position.